Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our current affair MCQ series, in which what we do, we daily discuss MCQs from your current affairs perspective. So today is 30 September, so let's see what are the questions for the day. So the first question is, quantum enabled science and technology program is an initiative of A. Department of Defense, B. Department of Science and Technology, C. ISRO, D. Department of Atomic Energy. So friends, answer is Department of Science and Technology, as is shown on your screen. So this is basically a rupees 80 crore project, and it is aimed at considerably ramping up research and development activities in this field that promises to grow important both strategically and economically. So it will ensure that nation reaches within a span of 10 years the goal of achieving the technical capability to build quantum computers and communication systems comparable with the best in the world, and hence earn a leadership role. So there are multiple facets of this program, so you can read about the details also by pausing the video. So it is a quite lengthy explanation, so it will consume a lot of time if we discussed it here. Next is your second question. So it is a quite lengthy explanation. Second question is, empower, replace, active, shake, hearts seen in news is related to A. Reduce cardiovascular diseases, B. Electric vehicle initiative, C. Solar power generation technology, D. None of the above. So friends, the answer is A, that is reduce cardiovascular disease. So basically in 2016 WHO and United States Centers for Disease Control and Prevention in 2016 launched this Global Hearts Initiative. So initiative comprises of five technical packages which provide a set of high impact evidence-based interventions that when used together will have an impact on improving global heart health. So on the prevention side, this Global Hearts Initiative comprises the Empower package. For tobacco control, in line with WHO Framework Convention on Tobacco Control, the Active package for increasing physical activity, the Shake package for assault reduction, and Replace package to eliminate industrially produced trans fat from the global food supply. So in the management side, there is an initiative called HEARTS. So these are basically different initiatives that this United States Disease Control and Prevention as well as this WHO has. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to pet animals in India. First, the animals included in all the schedule of Wildlife Protection Act 1972 are banned from keeping as pet animals. Second, elephant is an exception to the above act. Private persons can own elephant in India. So which of the above statements is correct? Let me tell you friends that only first statement is correct, that is one only. So second statement is not correct. So Wildlife Protection Act basically prevents selling and buying of wild animals as pet animals. So Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Rules 2018 regulates selling of pet animals through pet shops. Next is, Bathukama festival is celebrated in the state of A. Tamil Nadu, B. Kerala, C. Telangana, D. Karnataka. So we have to choose which of these states this Bathukama festival is celebrated. So friends, let me tell you, the answer is C, that is in Telangana. This Bathukama festival is celebrated in the state of Telangana. So festival is celebrated for 9 days during Durga Navratri. So it represents cultural spirit of Telangana. In Telugu, Bathukama means mother goddess come alive. So it is a state festival of Telangana. Every year this festival is celebrated as per Telugu version of Hindu calendar in Bhadrapada Amavasya, also known as Mahalya Amavasya. Let's move to the next question. Next is, INS Khanderi seen in news is related to A. Aircraft carrier, B. Submarine, C. Fast attack vehicle, D. None of the above. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that only one option will be correct, and that is submarine. So INS Khanderi is basically a submarine. So Union Defense Minister Rajnath Singh commissioned this INS Khanderi, the second indigenously built Scorpion class submarine, into the Indian Navy in the presence of Navy Chief Admiral Karambir Singh. So the diesel electric submarine possesses superior strength strength and major combat capabilities. So while commissioning it, this minister for defense minister Rajnath Singh reiterated Indian Navy's capability in ensuring the peace and stability in the Indian coastal regions. So this is about your this question. Let's move on to the next question. Let me tell you before moving on, friends, we have a project 75. It has been basically under which this submarine has been built. So India aims to build a total of 6 Scorpion class submarines in collaboration with France Transport Technology from Naval Group under the project 75 at a cost of around rupees 25,000 crore. So first Scorpion class submarine was INS Kalvari, which was commissioned into Indian Navy in December 2017. So next is consider the following statements related to transiting exoplanet survey satellite. First, it is controlled and operated by NASA. Second, its mission is to find planets outside our solar system. Let me tell you, friends, that both of these statements are correct. So the answer is C, that is both 1 and 2. So basically, transiting exoplanet survey satellite, it is a NASA mission that looks for planets orbiting the brightest stars in the Earth's sky. So it was led by Massachusetts Institute of Technology with seed funding from Google. So these are the more details about it. So you can pause the video and can check. Next, let's consider the following statements. First, Anamudi Peak is the highest peak anomaly in Anamalai Hills, also the highest point of peninsular India. Second, Anamalai Hills is present in the state of Karnataka. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you, friends, that only one statement is correct, and that is first statement. So answer would be A. So Anamudi Peak is basically the highest point of Anamalai Hills, also known as the highest point of peninsular India. So these are basically Palani Hills are a part of it, and they are made of Dhruvar igneous rocks, and they basically fall in the state of Tamil Nadu. And next question is, consider the following statements related to 6th schedule in the Indian Constitution. First, the 6th schedule deals with the administration of all the tribal areas in all the states of India as Article 244. Second, the district council and the regional council under the 6th schedule have real power to make laws possibility on the various legislative subjects, receiving grants in aid from the Consolidated Fund of India to meet the cost of the schemes for the development, healthcare, education, roads and regulatory powers to state control. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you, friends, that the second statement is correct. First is not correct because sixth schedule has only 4 tribal states and not all the tribal states. So solution is B. So you can read in detail more detail by referring to the Indian Polity book by Lakshmi Kant. And next is, consider the following statements related to Sundarbans. First, it is the largest mangrove forest in the world. Second, it is located in the state of Tamil Nadu. Third, it is home to Bengal tiger. Fourth, it is declared as Ramsar site, that is wetlands of international importance. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you, friends, that the answer is C, that is 1, 3 and 4, because second is not correct. It is not located in the state of Tamil Nadu. So some area of West Bengal is there. Sundarbans falls fall in West Bengal as well as the country, that is Bangladesh. So solution is C. So you can read about it in more detail by pausing the video. So various details have been given in it. Next is, extended producers responsibilities seen in news is related to A, e-waste management rules, B, plastic waste management rules, C, both A and B, D, none of the above. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is C. Friends, answer is C. Sorry, here is a typing mistake. So solution is C. It must be C and not A. So basically, extended producer responsibility is a kind of initiative that has been introduced, a regulatory provision that has been introduced in various types of waste management rules, so that the producers, the ultimate producers who produce a particular kind of waste, they have the responsibility to collect back and recycle such kind of waste, and that applies to plastic as well as e-wastes. So the more details you can check by seeing the pausing the video. So this is all about, friends, today's video. If you like the video, if you like the discussion, if you like the MCQs, then do ensure that you like our video and also share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And lastly, friends, if you want to remain in touch with various initiatives that we have for the purpose of CSE 2020, then you can join our Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen and will also be provided in the description box. So if in case you want to remain in touch with it with us, you can check the description box and can join the Telegram channel by using that link. And also friends, if you have any doubts, if you have any queries, you can mail us at achieveias21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at 8968920720. So lastly friends, we also have a website on which you can visit, and we keep on updating our website for the purpose of your preparation, where we upload various kinds of information which can be helpful for you people. So you can visit our website, you can also mail us or contact us for any queries. And lastly friends, if you want to subscribe to the PDFs of these MCQs, then also you can contact us or mail us. So obviously friends, we have kept a minimum fee for the subscription fee for the PDFs, that is rupees 99 per month. But that has been kept for the purpose of our motivation, so that we people can remain motivated to help you people. So if in case you are interested to join, then you do ensure that you contact us, or the link will also be provided in the description box, using which you can join our initiative or you can subscribe for the PDFs of these MCQs. So this is all about today's video. Thank you friends. Have a very nice day ahead.